Sometimes it's necessary to design a circuit that will control a larger load than the switch or the output of a device can handle. In the case of a computer, the maximum output from, let's say, the parallel port is about 20 milliamps, which is not enough to drive a load that needs considerably more current to operate it. This is a configuration where we need to ensure that the switch, like S1 here, when it's closed, will turn this transistor on. Now, the beta for this transistor is somewhere between 30 and 300. That's what the data sheet said. And if we pull one transistor out of here and put another one in, we still have to ensure that this circuit is going to work. So let's look at the math with this circuit. If we have enough current here, we will have enough current here. And worst case is a beta of 30. Let's see, the maximum voltage from here to here across this 10k ohm is 20 volts minus 0.7 volts for the base emitter junction is equal to 19.3 volts. When S1 is closed, the amount of base current is, let's see, 19.3 volts divided by 10k ohms. That's equal to, let me figure this out, that's equal to 1.93 milliamps. 1.93 milliamps times is the worst case scenario, so times which is the least amount of gain, times a beta DC of 100 is equal to 193 milliamps, which is possible that it could flow from collector to emitter. Collector to emitter current what would the voltage be across the or the voltage drop across RC so VRC would equal to IC max times RC. And if RC is 1K ohm, we would have 193 milliamps times 1K ohm. Let's see. And this didn't work. Yep, it did work. I just fat fingered my calculator. So 193 milliamps times 1k ohm is 193 volts. Well, that's kind of impossible when you look at it, because we've only got 20 volts VCC. What that ensures is the fact that there is enough current flow in this so that VCE is equal to 0 volts. We know from the data sheet, however, that VCE sat, when we have a saturation current through collector to emitter, that there is a 0.2 to 0.3 volt saturation voltage from collector to emitter. That's what VCE sat is. So never assume that a transistor is going to saturate to 0 volts, because it won't. Maximum amount of current in this circuit then would be 20 volts minus VCE sat. It's equal to about 19.8 volts. And 19.8 volts divided by 1K ohm equals 19.8 milliamps.